Hey you guys, what is up? It's your boy Blaze here, coming at you once again from Need Input. So check it out everybody, Megadeath is making a comeback after the lead vocalist Dave Mustaine has recovered from his throat cancer. Dave released a few of the new tracks on YouTube from the new album that comes out on September 2nd. So I thought it's a good time to cover some Mandela effects dealing with this band. So let's get started. Now I know this is an older Mandela effect, but I clearly remember the band name being Megadeath, spelled D-E-A-T-H, and not Death the way it is now. All through junior high school and high school, I listened to these guys and was a big fan, and I know for sure without a shadow of a doubt, their name was Megadeath, D-E-A-T-H. In fact, I still have an old high school folder from around 1996 and 97 where I used to write all the rock and metal bands I could think of down and had my friends write them on there as well. It's laminated hanging in my room as a memory right now. But there is something very interesting about it. I remember Megadeath being written here spelled at the top as D-E-A-T-H. But now there is a strange water stain or something right here at the top in the area where I wrote it. And I have no clue how the stain got there. But if you look closely, you can make out the M and the D. And in person, it's very, very hard to see, but I can tell I wrote Megadeath, D-E-A-T-H. As a teenager, my bedroom was filled with exotic car and band photos all over the place. Yep, that's me at age 16, my Born to Be Wild poster and Beavis and Butthead right behind me. My messy desk with my Super Nintendo and Nintendo 64 hooked up to an old Commodore 64 monitor. But as you can see, I got Slayer, Offspring, and all those other tiny photos on my wall are all album covers I owned. And in this photo, if you look to the right just above my dresser, you can't see it at all sadly, but this was a picture of Dave Mustaine holding a black guitar and it said Megadeath right above him in red letters. And I remember clearly that it said D-E-A-T-H. It's a real shame I don't have another photo of this where you can see it, because I really wonder if the Mandela effect changed it. The interesting thing is, it would seem so many others around remember them as Megadeath also, spelled D-E-A-T-H, as numerous newspaper clips list him as Megadeath. There are also numerous websites calling them Megadeath as well. And if you type in Megadeath into Google search and click on images, you can see just how many media companies, websites, and individuals list them down as Megadeath. Then click on videos and you can see how many people posted music videos or videos about the band and listed them down as Megadeath. Megadeath. Now back in 2015, WWE wrestler Dolph Ziggler came out wearing a jeans jacket with a Megadeath patch on it spelled Megadeath, D-E-A-T-H. Now a lot of people were quick to attack him all over Twitter for it, with even Dave Mustaine himself writing a tweet saying, "Is Megadeath misspelled on his entrance jacket? That's embarrassing. There's no A, man." The very next night when Ziggler came back out, the patch was fixed. The big question though is, where did he even get a patch spelled Megadeath spelling it that way, and how did he fix it so very fast? In 1992, Capitol Records released Symphony of Destruction and Breakpoint on vinyl to be used in jukeboxes all across America. They even printed the strips that were used to select the band on the jukeboxes themselves. But look how they spelled the band's name, Megadeath, D-E-A-T-H. Why would they get that wrong? Obviously, Megadeath was signed by Capitol Records, so Capitol knew the band name and how to spell it correctly, and they would have had the band and others look this over before even releasing it to the public. Moneybags covered this album 5 years ago. He had a friend from Germany contact him and send him these album photos that he found. His friend actually posted a photo of the album on Twitter to Dave Mustaine saying, "Explain." And Dave actually wrote back tweeting saying that's the original name of the band. But that doesn't make any sense. How could that be when Mustaine has always called the band Megadeath since they formed, spelled D-E-T-H? Not only that, Capitol Records released other vinyl albums back in 1986 and 1990 of the band and listed them as Megadeath, D-E-T-H. The band has never been called Megadeath with an A, though Mustaine got the band name idea from a pamphlet left behind by a California senator on a bus, which read, "The arsenal of Megadeath can't be rid, no matter what the peace treaties come to." The term Megadeath stuck in Mustaine's head, and he shortened it down to Megadeath without the A. He formed a band called Falling Angels, but later changed it to Megadeath, and that's what they've been ever called since. Vic Rattlehead has been Megadeth's mascot since they first debuted. A skull whose eyes are covered by a riveted-on visor, his mouth is clamped shut, and his ears are closed with metal caps. But here's the thing, I don't remember the metal caps on his ears. It looks very strange to me and just not right. I remember him having headphones on with chains hanging off of them. Now, I searched and searched for weeks looking for residue of the way I remember him, and the only photo I can find is this one, which is kinda close, but he doesn't have the visor on. But look, he is wearing headphones, and that's the way I remember it. Megadeth's hit song, A Tout Le Monde, came out in 1994, and was featured on their Euthanasian album. But some of the lyrics have been changed. At the beginning of the song, it used to go, "Don't remember where I was, I realized life was a game." But this is not what he says. It now goes, "I don't remember where I was, I realize life was a game. Very clearly he says this. Take a listen.
Don't remember where I was. I realize life was a game.
Then later, towards the middle of the song, he used to sing, "So as you read this, know my friends, I'd love to stay with you all." But now he says very clearly, "So as you read, know my friends, I'd love to stay with you all." The "this" has been totally removed. Take a listen for yourself. The crazy thing is, none of the lyric sites have changed. They all show the original lyrics the way it used to be. But that's not the only song change. On their album Hidden Treasures, released back in 1995, the song 99 Ways to Die has changed. Towards the end, he used to say, "There is only death and danger in the sockets of my eyes." But now he says, "There is only death and danger in the socket of my eye." Take a listen for yourself.
There is only death and danger in the socket of my eye. A playground of illusion.
So once again, the Mandela Effect has removed the S, or in this case, two S's. The official lyrics, however, still say "the sockets of my eyes." And on their 2004 album, The System Has Failed, the song The Scorpion has changed also. He used to say, "Then I treat you like a dog as I shoot my venom in. You pretend you didn't know that I am The Scorpion," hence the title, The Scorpion. However, he now says, "Then I treat you like a dog as I shoot my venom in. You pretend you didn't know that I am a scorpion." So it removed "the" and replaced it with "a." And finally, we have Symphony of Destruction, one of Megadeath's greatest songs off their 1992 album, Countdown to Extinction. The lyrics used to be, "Just like the Pied Piper, led rats through the streets. We dance like marionettes, swaying to the Symphony of Destruction." However, now twice in the song, at the beginning and at the end, he says we dance like the marionettes. However, in the middle of the song, he says it twice normally, which is just very bizarre. Take a listen. So there you have it, you guys. Megadeath Mandela Effects. What do you guys think? Let me know in the comment section down below. And until next time, it's your boys Blaze here from Need Input saying, remember, be kind, Rewind Your Mind. Peace out, everybody, and God bless.